Transcend TV.
Welcome one and all, I am Gogo Monsoon, here at the Tiger Cave, with my friend over here.
It's me, it's still me, Saffron Sunshine, and I'm here with Gogo Monsoon. It's nice to meet you here, and we're here in the Tiger Cave, we have a Tiger Challenge, here to give us info.
Yes, the various Tiger Challenge, originally used by the Tiger Cave to help the Tigers get stronger, help them build themselves up. Help them hone their skills. But ever since Jay Williams has gotten a hold of it, from what I've heard, it's taken on a more darker term, a more form of almost ridiculous punishment. Here we have the rules. 4 rounds without time limit. You win by pin, submission, or knockout. Again, we're going to keep it honorable. No use of any foreign objects, illegal moves, and no count out.
It's all pure. It's all fair. It's all simple. It's time to get it started here as we have the first man coming out here, and I'm very familiar with this man ever since his last match against Robin Martyr. Here comes the smoke, here comes the light, and here comes the wonderful
Vogan. Look at this man. The determination in his eyes. He makes his way to the stage. Last time he's actually been in Japan was actually in AWE Japan. I was almost confused for a second, but then I realized it was actually the match where Manuel Magnifico knocked Vogan out and took his place. So this time might be the first time he's actually returning to Japan to reclaim his title. To reclaim that match that was stolen.
No doubt, nobody to attack him from behind or anything. It's all Vogan. He's going up against 4 challenges here in this Tiger Challenge. As far as I know, this is not going to be easy.
Definitely not, especially with the first man we're going to see starting up. Ito Sakura, followed by Kid Tiger, War Tiger, and Tiger Mask number 9. Those are the 4 he has to take on.
I'm sure Vogan is willing to accept the challenge here, because if he didn't, we wouldn't be here. Vogan wouldn't have called us here to do commentary here for this challenge here. So I have some faith that Vogan can survive all 4 of these men.
Definitely.
And Vogan's ready, as you see. Let's bring it to the Titantron here. His first challenge, as you said, Ito Sakura. Given how he's going up against a man like Ito, this is going to be a very dangerous threat here, starting up here, given how he's the most recent member here at Tiger King.
Definitely. Research his background in terms of that he's connections to the Yakuza families of Japan. However, as you see here, he has a sort of form of respect, a sort of form of power that he brings, especially choosing, well, rather strangely, not to don the Tiger Mask.
Out of everyone here in this Tiger Challenge, Sakura's the only one who doesn't don the Tiger Mask, as you just said here. It's interesting.
Yes, I don't think that's because of his relative new status. I think that's just, he doesn't want to hide behind anything. He wants his face known all over the world as he saw that explosive entrance.
Hey man, I don't blame him. I mean, if you want to make yourself a superstar, you gotta show your face here in the wrestling business.
Sakura! Sakura!
Ito! Mixed reception by the fans here, not knowing what to think of this youngster. Making his way into the ring.
Hey, he's a lone wolf. We're gonna make a name for himself here. He's gonna do that against one of the well-recognized superstars that we have in the game today, and the one for Vogan.
I mean, look at the style of shoes he's wearing. The getup he has. As you can see, the heels are a bit exposed, using which will benefit his strike-based style, especially his rolling popo kick. Getting the straight bone to the face if it connects.
Knock any man out.
That's great. Oh my god! Beautiful dropkick into the corner, following up with another one! Wasting no time, and he's gonna go for a third!
He's not playing Persona 5. I think this is his last surprise.
Oh,
hesitation dropkick!
And he never saw it coming. Going to the top rope. Might be trying to finish this one off early. Diving footstep, and he hits!
I think this match could be over just like that.
One, two, three, no! Ito definitely being a bit disappointed there. Bogan rolling to the outside, trying to catch his breath. Trying to win the fans over here. Picking up a head of steam. Oh, wait, no, he's not going to do Tope. He's smarter than that. He's waiting for Bogan to come back in. He knows Bogan's still a little bit close to 80%. Oh, beautiful forearm exchange here.
Going back and forth, are they?
Oh, yeah.
Trying to figure out who strikes out the strongest here. That's very kudos to like here. It's all about who is the very strongest here in the wrestling ring. Both these men are going to do battle here against that. Wait a second, switching it up on him with those forearms, left and right.
Oh, my God. Wasting no time again. That big boot now going to the forearms and the punches to the face. Weakening his structure in his face to get hit that, to hit that Popo kick as best he can.
Yeah, setting up for it right now. Switching up to those knees right there.
Repeatedly, remorselessly. Not giving Bogan time enough to think. He knows that the suplex blaster, chicken wing master, relies on having the time and space and energy to think and wonder what he's going to do next to his opponent. He can't let Bogan think too long or else he'll come up with a strategy. Oh my god.
That may not be a good idea.
Going back to the test of strength.
Oh! I don't think that was a good idea.
No. Oh! Again, going back to that pro wrestling style you talked about. The sense of honor. I can take anything you dish me and give it back twice as hard.
Yeah, it's a battle between knife, that shop, and a kick. Oh!
Ooh. Oh, look at that. They're still going.
Every single kick in here, they just echo around the Steiger Cave.
Oh! Oh! Uh-oh. That one seemed to be too much for Bogan, crumpling to the floor almost. Able to get on one knee. Forearms again and again. And again, into the corner. Oh, my God. Oh,
keeping
Jesus
him corner
Christ.
With these shots and forearms. He is staying
again.
On him.
What's he going to go for here? Oh! Back to that beautiful drop kick. Going for the pin. One, two, three, no.
No one through that to have. Do you think both can outlast all four of these Tigers here in the Tiger Challenge?
I think, if anything, Bogan has been trained by the great Vernon Price, man of Wrestle Orchestra fame, also the man who taught Jay Logan how to wrestle in the ring, and I think Vernon Price might teach Bogan to withstand this pain, but I wonder if he even can. It's a test of wills, honestly, but there is a slim chance that he might pull through. It's not looking likely if he keeps taking more of those shots to the back.
Yeah, it's not looking good for Bogan here as he's taking all these spinal taps to the back. That's not going to go well.
No. Again, the ref checking in on him. Ito again showing that honor, letting the ref check his opponent out before doing any more damage, waiting for Bogan to get up. But also at the same time sizing up his enemy. What is he going to do? What else does he need to take Bogan out? Getting back up here. What's he going to do? Oh! Ito with that forearm into that kick! What?
Tell him to bring it on, off the ropes for Sakura.
Wait, oh, what the? Oh!
Nelson suplex, baby.
Oh my god. The suplex blaster just hit his first suplex. But as you can see here, the damage might have taken its toll. Again, he had to land very hard on his back to hit that suplex. Almost looked like it knocked him out as well. Ito slowly coming to his feet here.
I mean, given how the punishment that Sakura has been given to Bogan, you have to wonder how much energy does he have left in the tank?
Well, yeah, you're definitely right. It seems like Hogan is taking advantage of the tired Ito Sakura. Again, oh, what's this? Oh!
Jumping into Gertie from Bogan.
Into Gertie, beautiful. What's he going to go for here? Suplex. Oh! Jackhammer variation. One, two, three, no!
Not enough to put down Ito Sakura.
Exactly. Again, Bogan still trying to figure out ways to inflict the pain. Oh, dodges that kick. Whoa! Jesus!
Helping Nelson out of his own.
Right on the head.
Into an STF.
STF. Bogan has nowhere to go here. Bogan's. This is a true test of strength. Snap or tap here. Oh, what? He's finding something inside of himself. The ref's almost in the way. Ref moves away. Logan getting closer and closer to the ropes. But the more that STF is applied, the more he gets choked out. The more the damage on his head increases. Can he reach the rope? He's almost centimeters away, but those centimeters must feel like a freaking mile. And he gets it.
Thankfully enough. Second, got an ankle. Whoa. Oh no! Keeping him away from that rope.
Oh, he's dragging him back. Bogan's trying to hold on to something, anything, but Ito again bringing him into the center of the ring. Could be hard to see here.
Basically, tell him where do you think you're going? You ain't going away that easy. Looking in the STF once more.
Oh my God! That floor must feel like Bogan's crossing the Sahara Desert. Just trying to reach for that beautiful oasis that is the rope break, and he gets it again. Oh, what's this? Oh, a deadlift position. Deadlift German!
German suplex!
Oh my god! Wait, no! German!
German suplex of all
the time! Oh, pick up!
Sakura! German suplex of his own! How is Bogan doing this?
Oh my god!
How is Sakura doing this? Dear god!
The test of strength has revived itself again!
No! Hollywood Lariato!
Hollywood, the show-stopping Lariat. Here we go. One, two, no. Ito getting to the ropes.
Ring Jesus awareness Christ. From Sakura is on display here in this Saga Challenge.
The crowd is on fire here. Bogan trying to set up something here.
There it is. It's gonna be huge. Cutthroat signal.
Goes. Oh!
Trying to go for that Narcissus kiss.
Oh!
Using his head for the advantage.
Oh my god, and Ito is on fire. Oh, what's he doing? What? Oh, he's trying to show respect. Oh no! No! Diamonds rain! The Hammerlock DDT variation, Diamonds rain. He hits it.
I don't think that was a good idea doing that against a man like Bogan.
Two, three,
KO.
The Honor got the best of Ito. But definitely Ito Sakura can go home to his family, go home to the fans, go home to the Tiger Cave and show that he's definitely got what it takes.
Nothing to be ashamed of here for Ito Sakura. He did his absolute best. He made a simple mistake, but you can't give him too much pressure.
No. And especially going up with someone like Bogan right now.
Mm-hmm. As we await for the second challenger here. He got one out of the way. He got three more opponents to go. Here comes the second.
Round two.
That said, Kid Tiger, one of the most natural talents that we have here in this arcade.
Definitely. He's definitely what some might call the antithesis to Jay Williams' style. Very not pro wrestle. I've seen him wrestle in places like Mexico, picking up lucha-style moves. Which, again, antithesis of Jay's Tiger Cave principle. But it has gotten him a lot of respect with the fans, as you can see here.
Yeah, but not for Jay Williams. That's it. If you've seen a Kid Tiger match, you know that he's out here to have fun. Not to Jay Williams like in here, but Kid Tiger is still here today, looking to do his absolute best to entertain the crowd here. Showing us something we probably have not seen before.
Definitely.
Especially if he's not careful, then well, we could see Bogan take a backslide driver.
And his 450 splash. But as well as that, it's going to be weird because both men have very inventive styles of wrestling, very inventive styles of movement and application of abilities. Big Tiger showing his respect to the fans for coming out here tonight.
Well, you have to keep
Trying to go for a punch.
I was going to say, keep in mind, this is not a case where another opponent comes out and he's like 100%. No. He has to continue wrestling no matter what.
Yes. And of course, the winner, of course, oh! Trying to psych him out with an elbow of his own. But going back to what I said, the winner of this gets Jay's respect and the Tiger's gold medal. A time-honored prize, a heritage item that many got in the past, but ever since, Jay Williams has also really closed off the Tiger Cave and has not really done the Tiger Cave Challenge in a long time. And even when he does it, no one has ever really gotten past the fourth round.
So you have to question, will Logan be the only one to be able to break that curse of the Tiger Challenge here?
I don't know. But if anything, it seems very likely. Again, Hogan is a veteran. I mean, it's surprising that he doesn't honestly have a belt in a lot of promotions. The way he's able to apply himself, get himself out there, able to learn from his mistakes every match. But as we're seeing here, Kid Tiger was trying to weaken the already injured leg of Hogan. Oh, look at that.
Keeps going with his shin. Arm with by different Kid Tiger, and he's up to his feet, calling it a tie up between the two again.
Yep, going into the headlock position here.
You gotta know, for Bogan here, it's more like he's against speed here, since Kid Tiger is a very speedy competitor here in this match. Shoulder block, whoa, goes under, jumping over.
Yes, this is definitely a match of speed versus power here.
Oh, wait a second, Gogo Monsoon. I think I have an idea what he's going for here. This is trademarked Tiger Mask. We could be seeing that Tiger Fang kick.
Oh, no!
Bogan is not with any of that, but Kid Tiger
has to let him go easily!
Jesus, and the fans chanted his name there. Beautiful application. That diving elbow right there. Now, again, what I talked about beforehand, the ingenuity of both these performers. Going to the top rope here. It's going to go for. Diving senton. Up the ropes.
Senton punches, trying to go for a clothesline. Whoa! Trying to go for it again. Jesus Christ, what's happening? Oh, hands!
Oh!
Okay. Rocket to the back of the head.
Right on the head.
He does have some immaturity here, and Bogan is not a big fan of that. And wait, whoa.
No. If it's one thing Bogan tolerates, it's professionalism. Even if some people might call his methods dirty or very trick-oriented, at least he likes to show respect for the craft. Doesn't really care for that showboating. He's going to drill these punches into Kid Tiger here.
And you know, unlike the others, Bogan knows how to get it done. He's done it before.
Yes, yes.
He's showing that strength, that Hercules type
Hercules.
Tight body he got right there.
Ken going back to drilling these punches. His opponent's been tossing around the ring. This is, again, Hogan's natural ability to shift his style up when it matters. He's able to look at his opponent and automatically think, hey, how can I dismantle my opponent in the best way possible? And what we're seeing, gut-wrench position here. Oh!
Go for that suplex, blast the combo.
Definitely, here we go. Will he hit the second one? Yes, he does. Drag him into the center, trying to keep Kid Tiger away from any possible escape. He's going for the third here.
Third time's the charm.
Oh!
And he got it!
Beautiful application.
No way, he's not done. Wait a goddamn second.
No. Whoa!
Oh! Throwing his shoulder right to the ring post.
Lon darting him right into the corner. Here we go. Hogan going to the outside. Again, he needs to rest, he needs to recuperate. The best way to do that is the outside. He did it with Ito Sakura, but it just might be different for Kid Tiger. Kid Tiger really building up ahead of steam here. Will he go?
Off the rope.
Oh!
Letting him snap for it.
Building up ahead of steam, and Bogan just knocked all that steam out. And again.
Oh! A shot back with that enziguri.
Beautiful application from Kid Tiger. Hogan's slowly getting up here.
This may be Kid Tiger's chance to do something very special here in this match.
Oh my god. He's warming up. Here we go!
Hogan won none of it. He's just messing around here.
Again. He's like, I can play the mind games. You know, the best option Kid Tiger has in this competition. Is to work on those mind games. Oh!
Kid Tiger off the ropes. Wait, whoa!
Leg
wait,
trip
is he
into the?
Is he gonna? No! No! Bogan's not really gonna go for what I think he's going for.
He's got the core strength to do it, but I don't know if he should.
Can he do it? Will he do it?
No!
Kid Tiger won none of that. No!
Kid Tiger quick on the draw. Here we go.
Once again, playing with him for a second. Wait a second. Wait, whoa. Oh! Sweeping the leg and falls up with a tope up Tomiko.
Beautiful application there. One.
Leg is hooked.
Two. Three, no.
Not enough to put away the one from Hogan. You know, it's still amazing to see how Hogan is even able to stay in this match, regardless of all the hell he went through in the first and currently right now.
Definitely. What's this? Almost King's Knuckle variation set up here.
Whoa! Oh no, here we go again.
Steer right.
Diamond's Reign. For the second time with this match.
One. No, what?
Excuse me?
I can't believe it.
Go. I want to analyze something on that one. He kicked out of one, right?
Yeah.
Can you explain
to me? Is he actually superhuman? Jeez, oh my god!
I think just answering your question here as he's firing up!
Jesus! The strength of a thousand fans Ooh. Flow through him! Ooh!
Knee to the face.
Combination of kicks! The combination kicks drilling into Hogan!
Notice how Hogan is still getting up after all of those kicks! Oh, right Ooh. To the head!
Beautiful combination there! Oh, up and over!
Wait a second!
Oh, here we go!
Tiger, fake kick!
Beautiful! The fans chanting. Is he gonna go for? Oh! Beautiful leg drop from the top rope.
One, two, no! That would have done the job right there. I think all that Kid Tiger needs to do is hit that backslide driver. Or that 450, Definitely. Whatever may work.
I don't know, maybe he's setting up for
it. Oh, here we go! He's going for we know!
Oh, what's he gonna go for? Whoa!
Chicken wing! Chicken wing!
Chicken wing! Oh my god, it might be time. He might see the light here. Kid Tiger's got nowhere to move to. He's already been worked on a little bit from that brutal drop kick to the back of the head. And he might just have to pass out now. He's had his turn and now it's over.
Kid Tiger did everything that he could, but not enough to put down the wonderful Bogan here as he lasts in the second round.
Beautiful, and now we see Bogan's a little bit tired here. He's getting his little breaks in between entrances, but it still might not be enough.
You want me to be honest, Yogo Monsoon? The past two competitors, it's been a little easy. I don't think for this one that's coming up. I'm very worried for Bogan's sake, given his third challenge here in the Tiger Challenge.
Yeah, I am afraid for anyone that would face a man called War Tiger.
War Tiger signed up Bogan's name on the death note.
I mean, this is just gonna be brutal. The enforcer of the Tiger Cave, War Tiger. Probably one of the many reasons why nowadays people don't even get past the third round.
I think what I do.
Part Samoan, part Japanese, part tank from the looks of it.
My god, I don't know how Bogan's even gonna last here in this one. This is a very dangerous man out of anyone here in the Saga Challenge.
Definitely, and again, this, unlike the other two, there's not a lot to say about War Tiger. We don't even know generally what he was like before the Tiger Cave, I mean. But like some say, he was probably a completely different person. God knows what that person was before. But I wonder if it's long gone right now.
Yeah, without a doubt, given how this was Supreme Tiger's last ever student before it, being taken in by Jay Williams himself.
Right? Do you wonder where Supreme Tiger went?
I don't know. I can't even say, given how I'm not very keen on the Tiger Mask legacy here. Especially with these Tigers that we're seeing here in this Tiger Challenge.
Oh, what's this? I'm trying to waste no time!
Do you really think that's a smart idea?
I don't know. Maybe he's trying to borrow something from Ito Sakura. But it ain't working.
Not a doubt being thrown up and brought back down to the ground. Excuse me.
Tossing him around like a ragdoll here.
I was going to say earlier, we saw that Kid Tiger had that backslide driver. This is anything unlike the backslide driver. We're talking about the vertebraker.
The vertebraker could end this match at any time. Remember, Ito Sakura has given dangerous amounts of damage to Bogan's head. Not to mention Kid Tiger exhausting Bogan. Now this man's gonna just squeeze Bogan like a trash compactor.
As you say that, Thick Dice is gonna kill some lives here in this one as he got that head scissors being applied here.
See his help.
Attacking the sides. You gotta give Bogan some credit here. Staying alive here in this challenge, despite him going up against a man like War Tiger.
Yeah, it's something. I mean, I've only seen like small pictures or videos of what War Tiger does to smaller people in pro wrestling Japanese matches. But God knows what he's going to do to a man like Bogan. Especially that this might be the first like prime time event that the Tiger Cave has had since Dastardly's World Tour. All these Tigers are here to show and have shown their stuff. So I can only expect that War Tiger is going to try and destroy Bogan.
Now, oh, he's trying to get a hold of him there, but Bogan was able to kick him away. Now trying to go for, oh!
Jesus Christ, that backdrop suplex right onto Bogan's neck. Bogan Any of these moves could send Hogan to the hospital, honestly.
Without a doubt, this may be his last match if he's not careful enough.
Ooh! These shots being heard all the way around the ring. Oh!
Going for a knee.
Misses that opportunity.
That could be the advantage that Hogan needs here, going up against a man like Ward Zeiger. If you notice, there's a difference between these two. Despite the height, despite the weight, there's one thing that Hogan needs to capitalize on, it's those knees. Because you notice, his knees is very unpadded here compared to Hogan's.
Just zero protection. It's almost like, and it's almost like it's his real only way to match up against the War Tiger. I mean, he can't easily trick anyone else. This guy is determined. Oh,
smacking
Jesus.
The living taste out of his mouth. I think his taste buds are gone.
Smacked him. Those palms almost astral projected Bogan's soul out of his body. Bogan trying to also use the momentum of War Tiger against him, but it's not working.
Broke his war. Wait, what in the? Oh dear God, what's happening?
What?
Oh dear God, what's happening?
Oh!
Yep, we were just talking about it.
Again.
That's an easy target for War Tiger here.
Yep, and using that momentum off the ropes in order to create velocity to maximize the potential damage to that knee. You know, I've actually hurt my kneecap before. And if you've ever, like, dislocated or slightly injured your knee, that's just pain. Every movement will become pain for War Tiger. But I wonder if that will just only make War Tiger more pissed off.
I doubt as Hogan continues to work on that knee right now. Now, wait a second. This looks a bit familiar.
Sito Sakura's STF variation. It's almost like he's learning through pain, trial by fire here. And just like Hogan before, War Tiger's gonna try and go for the ropes. It's easier for him considering his frame advantage and strength advantage, and he gets it. Still though, the pain must be grueling.
That's right, War Tiger got a lot of advantages here against Hogan, but a lot of disadvantages here, except for one, that's just working on it right now, working on that knee of War Tiger.
Yes, yes. Shinbreaker. Oh! Countered with a drop kick by War Tiger, and War Tiger once again, momentum shifts back to him. Gotta wonder. Hogan has faced a lot more like high velocity, technical style opponents. And he's never faced this much power before, especially at this state. I mean, consider like Robert Martyr. That was an endurance test of its own, but he was 100% when that fight went on. Now he's probably like 30%. He's running on fumes, and he's got to fight through that pain and figure out how to possibly counter War Tiger as War Tiger lets out that beautiful roar. The fans are sizing up for something big here.
We were questioning about earlier if Hogan was even able to handle or even last long in this challenge, and we're seeing it right here, but against a man like War Tiger, how long can that last? As War Tiger hit that deadly big boot to the side of Hogan's face.
Yes, face wash combination akin to almost Namo style, but Namo Muay Thai, very smaller frame. That was like if a log came up and shot you straight in the face after you've already fallen down a hill.
Without a doubt.
War Tiger keeping it in the corner. Looking these punches.
Oh! Those hand bones right at the there. Body of Bogan here.
And he may have learned from the previous experience that couple, the opening minutes of the match, Hogan needs that velocity, so what do? Trap him in a corner. Make sure he can't possibly get out. And we're now seeing the effect that this strategy has taken on Hogan.
Yeah, Hogan's not looking too good compared to what we saw earlier.
Oh!
You gotta give Hogan some credit. He's staying in this fight regardless here.
Just throwing some classic punches. I think he calls it, excuse me, magic hands.
maybe a little bit of legal hit given how we're in Japan.
Whoa, God!
Looks like they're actually gonna.
I have to ask you a question. You ever seen a thick boy fly before?
Oh no, I'm assuming it's like a bomb, a tank shell. Oh
dear God!
A miss. That heat-seeking missile missed its
target.
You ever
seen a man like Hogan die? Oh!
Well, that answers the question.
Jesus Christ. Almost mirroring before with Kid Tiger. It's almost like karma.
Oh, yeah, without a doubt, as War Tiger is definitely making Hogan pay for that, as we're on the outside.
Tiger's getting ready. He's sizing up. Might be going for a big boot into the corner.
Bicycle kick!
Traditional style bicycle kick, just sending shockwaves throughout Bogan's body, Bogan. Basically, I'm not even sure how he's able to stand. No countouts, of course, so War Tiger can take all the time he generally needs.
Do whatever he damn well pleases. He's in control. Another bicycle kick by War Tiger.
Beautiful bicycle kick. These strikes, they're basic, but they hurt. I don't know if Hogan's even, like, lucid at this point. War Tiger taking him around the corner, trying to give him a world tour with those big boots. Hogan, however, fighting out just a little bit.
I'm trying to give him a full-force massacre. Oh! Using the head of his.
Jesus Christ. Smart application there. Again, putting him into the corner, finally, going to go for that next bicycle kick. Oh my God, letting that bestial cry. And here we go!
Going right back to the legs.
Oh. Yes, it is. Again, took advantage. Hogan, almost like the Cobra that was El Magnifico, waiting for his opportune time to strike. And here we go! Beautiful drop kick into the corner. Now Hogan taking his time on the outside. This works better for Hogan, honestly, in my opinion. He's got more time to recollect, more time to think, more time to save his breath. He throws War Tiger in there. War Tiger trying to find a way to get back up. Oh,
whoa! Sleeper hold!
God! Traditional sleeper hold knocked off to Hogan. Hogan able to slip out there. Beautiful application. Oh!
Power slam, and you saw he said that this is a done deal.
Yes, it is. No! Hogan, I don't know, man. He's made of strong stuff. As I said, Vernon Price battle-tested him. He's also been through a hell of a match with some other popular wrestlers. But this might be his biggest ordeal yet. Oh, he tried to get out of Tiger's grip, but no. Able to reverse it. Beautiful pinning to Broken Rana's. Here we go. Body splashes by Hogan.
He's usually set up for something huge. Another body splash by Hogan.
He's trying to get that velocity in like Ito Sakura. Like he needs to. He's learning and he's learning and he can't stop. He won't stop coming. That train will never stop.
Unless you're War Tiger with that Urinage.
Oh my God. He was like, sit your silly ass down. What's he gonna go for here?
Sizing him up in the corner. Whatever War Tiger's gonna do, this could be the end right here. Watch this.
Bicycle! Oh! Hogan dodged it, kept his breath a little bit. Diamond Rain!
He put away two opponents with that Diamond Rain. Well, he put away
two
into a Sakura, but not War Tiger.
Yes. Oh my God! Hogan's cry of frustration. Jesus Christ!
I mean, you gotta feel for Hogan. I mean. He hit that diamond drain on two opponents. The first time he got him a three count. The second time he got somebody to keep up. The third time it's not working at all.
Right? Third time is definitely not the charm here. Oh, War Tiger tossing Vogan over. Gonna go for a spear into the corner? Wait, no, Vogan dodging it. Again going for that roll-up attempt.
Nice counter.
One, two, three, no. No, only a two. Almost a 2.9 there. I had to second guess myself there for a second. Vogan is trying to hit this beautiful clover leaf. Wrenching in deep. War Tiger might have to snap or tap here. Again, working on those legs might have paid off. War Tiger's frame not big or flexible enough to reach for the ropes.
Yeah, without a doubt. I think this is what Vogan needs in order to at least win this challenge. He could possibly be facing up against Shane Williams. That is, if War Tiger waits.
Wait,
oh,
what?
Jackknife Man, one, two, what? They did
it! Oh my god!
That does it!
He did it! He pulled War Tiger up! Using that frame, using the injured legs in order to secure a victory. Not using Diamond Drain, not using the chicken wing, but rather combining his knowledge that he's learned so far and that he will continue to learn. I wonder what it's going to be like when he takes the match to Jay Williams in the next round.
I don't know if you see that.
Oh my god!
War Tiger is not happy with these results.
No, he's not. No, no, he's got the underhook in. He's switching it over. Vertebreaker!
I was saying, I don't know if you see that, but you see the bruise under Vogan's eye after this match has happened.
It's going to get worse.
Oh, yeah, without a doubt.
No. Oh!
Enough is enough,
second
Tiger.
One. Jesus. Vogan doesn't have the endurance to withstand or try and find a way out of these moves.
No.
He's helpless as he keeps getting dropped on his neck. Jesus Christ. Three vertebrakers in a row. Three finishers in a row. After almost a grueling around 40 minutes of combat. 40 minutes of combat.
We're talking about this may be Vogan's last match, and I think after that, that could answer our questions.
I mean, the ref might call it off, but I think the fact Jay Williams is calling for this match to continue.
Final round.
Picking up the scraps like a hyena, even though he's wearing the Tiger's mask.
He faced off against all three of the Tigers, and now he has to go against the King of the Tigers.
I don't think this is a fight. This is a straight up beatdown.
No, this ain't just a beatdown. This is just a showcase of how great Jay William is.
Master strategist. Not even like using the traditional Tiger's music.
Jay Williams can do whatever he damn well pleases. It's his Tiger Cape now. One thing that we do know of Jay Williams is that he's a very dangerous man. Don't let the looks fool you. Because if he locks you in with that chin too far, this match may be over more than 2 seconds.
I don't know if we need to worry about any of that. As you see, he's just taking his time to the ring. He sprays the Isenzu even before the match starts. Looking over his prey, like I said before, like a hyena, like a bottom feeding man. A bottom feeding animal, just like a raccoon trying to feed off the scraps that his cronies, his students have left behind. Just talking all sorts of smack to him. But Bogan! Bogan fighting back, but no! The Ascensu Claw locked on!
I don't think that was smart.
No, but he's gotta go out the way he wants to. We can all support Bogan for that. Like any performer, like any athlete, he's gonna go out the way he wants to. The way he designs it. He's not gonna just roll over and let someone just hit him.
Jay Williams does it his way and his way only. And he still hits him that here as Bogan, unfortunately, has lost the Tiger Challenge.
Almost uncaring face of Jay Williams there.
Another day in the job of King of the Tigers.
You don't get that, like, man, by just messing around. Disrespect. Complete disrespect! This Jay Williams is giving Bogan right now.
Almost as soon as saying, I'm glad you made it this far, but get the hell out of my tiger cave.
Alright. Well, I guess this is Gogo Monsoon and Sumi signing off. I don't know. We're gonna wait to see if Bogan's okay.
You gotta give Bogan some respect here. All the stuff that he's went through in this match, you can't help but show Bogan some respect.
Oh, look at that black eye got bigger.
Yeah, I was saying earlier, during that match against War Tiger, he went through a lot.
He tried to adjust his... Respect. Oh! Oh my god! What was that?
Almost like a knee. Wait, Gogo, you see that, right? That looks familiar, don't you think?
Oh my god!
No.
Oh my god!
That's not who I think it is. Oh dear god,
it is! Vernon Price, the truth, has returned to pro wrestling.
And I think he's very disappointed with this student.
Definitely. Jesus Christ. What does this mean for the Tiger King? What does this mean for, like, wrestling in general?
More importantly, what does this mean for Bogan's sake here?